We gonna blow up a volcano? All right. Am I gonna need to stand back? How does this work? I'm afraid. Oh gosh, do I need to put on the goggles?
Hey, Inverse, I'm Dr. Anjali Bhimani, and we
are about to make a volcano erupt today, which is very exciting. It's a very
tiny volcano for a very tiny human
who happens to be wearing, like, her mom's lab coat. I don't know what this is about. I'm gonna wrap it around myself, like, four times. Okay, make your volcano erupt. Fill a measuring cup with 1 cup of water. That I can do. I was good in some sciences, biology and anatomy. Chemistry, I didn't have that much of a knack for. I was always afraid of all the science experiments. The idea that I could blow up a classroom pretty much just stunned me into complete paralysis. I am a gamer. Here's the thing though, I am terrible at first-person shooters. I do not have the space awareness to understand where I am in space when I'm looking at the screen, and most of my most well-known games are first-person shooters. So when people ask me, do you play as yourself? Is it weird hearing yourself? I'm like, I haven't even gotten past the training module with some of these games. So no, it's not weird. In one game, I just yell at myself in my own voice, which is really lovely. Add 1 big scoop of eruption powder A and eruption powder B in the top of the volcano. So when I was 8 years old, my beautiful brother, Anish, got me the basic D&D set. And I fell in love with it. That was my intro to gaming. You know, when I was a little girl, I lived in a predominantly Caucasian community as a young Indian woman. And it could have been very easy for me to feel like I was so different that I couldn't have the same kind of life. But when I was playing D&D, a halfling could kill a red dragon. So it meant that it didn't matter how little I was, where I came from, what I was good at, what I was bad at, didn't matter, I could still be the hero. So I felt like I was other than everyone around me, but I never felt like I was othered. It was always a place at the table for me.
Okay, pour the water into the top of the volcano a little at a time and stand back as the volcano erupts. Ooh, 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 there she blows. This looks a little bit like Mordor, I'm not gonna lie. It's got a very Lord of the Rings vibe to it. There's lava everywhere!
Okay, this is very satisfying.
The bubbling lava is the result of a chemical reaction between the citric acid and sodium bicarbonate in your eruption powder.
Who knew? These guys knew. They wrote the thing. They knew. Okay, so now, part two. We're gonna make our volcano erupt extra loud! See what I did there? Pop crystals contain pressurized carbon dioxide inside a hard sugar coating. When moisture dissolves the coating, the carbon dioxide bubbles escape, making a popping and sizzling sound. Okay, here we go. Part two, fill a measuring cup with 1 cup of water. Haha, it's already half filled. So look, we're halfway there. There's definitely a vibe, a little more of a comedic vibe, like improv comedy vibe at D20. And at Critical Role, I feel like we lean into more serious stories sometimes there. But the fact is, there are different sides of the same coin. And even though D20 might have more comedic leanings, there are incredibly dark and incredibly poignant moments there. And the same thing with Critical Role. I mean, I have snort laughed multiple times, many, many times, probably more times than I care to count, watching or being a part of a show on Critical Role. So really just the difference is the people. They're all extraordinary people. Oh, here it is. Here's the special ingredient, guys. Okay. Pop crystals. I think I'm quickly getting over my fear of blowing things up, and now I just want to blow it up. When I was the age that I was when I first started gaming, there weren't roles like this out there available. I didn't have people who looked like me or sounded like me or came from the same background as me to look up to as superheroes, and now I get to play them, which is crazy. There is indeed a grandeur to being classically trained and the language that you use, but ultimately, it really is so much about character development and about knowing how to tell a good story. I think we might have to wing this a little bit and, like, maybe not necessarily use the scoop. Can we do science off the rails? Because this isn't work. Mom? Hey, Mom, Mom? I'm pretty sure scientists are not supposed to have nails this long, so there's that. But, you know, we're doing glam science today, you guys. It's glam.
Cool. We gonna blow up a volcano? Am I gonna need to stand back? How does this work? I'm afraid.
You know how they say don't try this at home? Oh, 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 ah. I feel like you should try this at home but use pop crystals that haven't already been activated, and then it'll be really loud. Here, I'm gonna make the sound. Pop! Poppity pop pop! Pop! Oh my god, you guys! We did science! Look at that!
We have experiment number two, and I'm even more nervous about this one.
A more aerodynamic paper airplane. Not all glider aircraft are equal. To find the most efficient design, take
a paper and make a paper airplane. Design.
Okay, we're gonna see what that means, y'all. Oh god, there's so many great memories from making Ms. Marvel. I don't even know where to begin. I do remember one moment. We were shooting this scene outside of the mosque where the kid is like stranded up on the roof and about to fall down. And Ms. Marvel is about to make her first appearance as like a hero to save the day. It was like 2:30 in the morning. And it was freezing outside, and we were dressed like it was spring because of the when it was supposed to be in the show. It should have been miserable, but I was so happy, and everyone was in such a good mood, and we were having so much fun that I did not care that I was freezing because we were just having such a great time.
Such a great time, I miss them.
All right, you guys. Thankfully, they have created this handy sheet so I can build my numbers.
One. Cover the number with the fold.
Symmetra, my favorite thing about her is that she has taken all of the obstacles and all of the difficulties that she has had throughout her life and throughout her history and used them as an impetus to do more good in the world. Everything that she is trying to do comes from this place of wanting to make the world a better place, and I think it's very, very noble. Plus, she, like me, runs around all day in high heels, and I can respect that. I can respect a girl who can be a superhero in high heels, because I'm wearing these, y'all. You guys, I feel like I'm doing it. I don't know if I am, but literally all I'm doing is looking at the numbers. I don't even know what this thing looks like right now, but we're about to figure this out. I love Anna, who's Farah's mom and who happens to be, you know, a sniper, because I think I want to grow up and be her. She's like Helen Mirren to me. If there was a Middle Eastern Helen Mirren, that would be who would play on. I also love Sombra just because she's such a sassafras. She's so sarcastic. All right, we're home stretch, home stretch. A cut on the dotted lines. What is this dark magic? Okay. Oh, I see. These are the flap. Oh, save yourselves, guys. Save yourselves. Look out. That was very aerodynamic, you guys. That was excellent. Thank you so much, Inverse. I'm gonna put these goggles on now for no reason because it makes me feel cool. I feel like I was cheated that I didn't get to wear these, and now I'm gonna sport these and say, signing off, Inverse.